What's up guys, Brad here. In this video, I'll be reviewing the SVS PB2000 Pro ported subwoofer. Can this $900 subwoofer blow the doors off my house and knock some stuff off my shelves? Well, let's find out, and hint, it kinda does. Now I do want to thank SVS for sending this subwoofer out to me for review, but they didn't sponsor this video, they didn't pay me to say anything, and they didn't have any involvement in this review other than sending the product to me. My opinions are my own and are based on my own personal experiences with the subwoofer itself. If you're interested in the PB2000 Pro or any other SVS sub, I'll put links in the description below if you want to check them out. Also, if you're new to the channel, consider hitting that subscribe button as I post new home theater and gaming related content every single week. And if you'd like to help and support the channel for free, consider using my Amazon affiliate links in the description below, which I do get a small commission from. Now, with all that said, let's go ahead and dive into the review. Let's start out by going over the tech specs. The PB2000 Pro is rocking a front-firing 12-inch high excursion driver with dual 3-inch ports on the front, a 550-watt RMS Class D sledge amp, and a frequency response of 16Hz to 290Hz in ported mode and 17Hz to 290Hz in sealed mode. On the back, you'll find a port for the SVS SoundPath wireless audio adapter, RCA stereo ins and outs, a 12-volt trigger input, as well as push-button controls for the intelligent control interface, which allows you to adjust things like phase, polarity, and the three parametric EQs. You can also adjust all of this using the SVS Smartphone app, which I'll talk about more a little later. All of this is enclosed in a ported subwoofer housing that's 20.9 inches high, 17.3 inches wide, and 23.6 inches deep with the grill on, and weighs roughly 65 pounds. As far as build quality goes, this is a hefty boy. It's a pretty massive sub compared to the SVS SB1000 I recently reviewed, and I could even fit inside the box it shipped in. The ported enclosure is extremely sturdy with an extra thick layer of MDF on the front baffle. Unlike many of SVS's other offerings, the PB2000 Pro is only available in their premium black ash finish, so if you have other speakers that are piano gloss black, for example, they don't offer a finish to match. I personally prefer the black ash finish anyway, but if you're one who likes their finishes to match from speaker to sub, then it's something you'll have to consider if you're looking at the PB2000 Pro. Now, just like the other SVS products I've reviewed, the PB2000 Pro comes with a cloth speaker grille, along with the same hard plastic frame and hard plastic pegs. It uses the same style pin cup system for attaching and detaching the grille, and it's really rigid and sturdy when attached, meaning it won't come flying off when playing intense bass sections or if tons of air are being pushed out of the ports. It really would be great if SVS had the same type of metal grille featured on their Ultra Series subs, but the cloth grille gets the job done and looks fine as is. Setting up the PB2000 Pro is pretty simple. Once you have it hooked up to your receiver, you can either use the push buttons on the back of the sub to set everything up, or a better option would be to use the SVS Smartphone app. In my testing for this review, I found the app to be much more intuitive and easy to use over the buttons on the back, so I'll mainly be focusing on the app. Now, using the app will make your life much easier during setup though. It means that while level matching your subs to the rest of your speakers, you can simply adjust the volume in the app instead of having to walk to the sub and change it there. Or if you're using REW to measure your subs and want to dial in the parametric EQ, you can do all of that without having to get up, making the process that much quicker. The app allows you to essentially adjust everything on the sub, including the low pass filter, phase, polarity, three different parametric EQs, enabling or disabling room gain compensation, and switching between ported and sealed tuning modes. There are also presets that you can adjust individually and load them up whenever you want, which is great if you like to have a bit more bass for your movies and music, but maybe less so for games. Now, coming off the heels of reviewing the SVS SB1000 sealed subwoofer, I expected there to be a big upgrade in sound quality and overall output moving to the ported PB2000 Pro, but holy crap, I was not expecting to be this blown away. The PB2000 Pro literally wiped the floor with the SB1000 in terms of output, extension, and room pressurization. I played quite a few games, watched a ton of movies, as well as my go-to demo scenes, and listened to a lot of music. The PB2000 Pro handled them with zero issues. In fact, I've seriously never felt bass extension this deep in my home theater ever. I must have rewatched the opening scene in Ready Player One, near the race scene, so many times that my wife likely felt like having me committed. The Artemis, the Sixer Fixer, I've watched all her walkthroughs, her Twitch streams, it's her, It's definitely her. I just couldn't get over how my room was filled with this deep, pressurizing bass when the T-Rex came stomping through, or when King Kong showed up and all hell broke loose. The bass was tight, clean, and packed one heck of a punch, to the point where I actually started worrying about things falling off my shelves. It was really like watching the movie for the first time all over again. In terms of gaming performance, the PB2000 Pro handled it just as well as it did movies. I had the opportunity to borrow my friend's PS5 recently and played through all of Spider-Man Miles Morales. And let me tell you, the sound mix on that game is top notch. Here again, bass was tight, deep, and really pressurized the room when dealing with Rhino in the beginning of the game. I was hearing, and more importantly, feeling bass in moments that called for it. Nothing like a little couch shaking to get you immersed in the game, am I right? And if you're listening to music, then I have to say that this is one of the most musical subs that I've heard ever. Like I said earlier, it's not as articulate as a sealed sub when in ported mode, however, it makes up for an overall output and extension. I do want to note that my review was done with the sub in ported mode, but you do have the option to run it in sealed mode by plugging up the ports on the front and changing the port tuning in the app. The sub doesn't come with any foam plugs though, which would have been a nice addition, so I was not able to test it in this way, though I'm told that they are available through SVS if you really need or want them. You'll obviously lose some output going to sealed, and the frequency response changes slightly, but it is nice to have the option if you want a bit more articulation and response. Now, SVS does also offer an SB2000 Pro, which is a sealed version of this sub, so if space is a factor and you want a sealed enclosure anyway, that one may be worth considering over this one. So is the PB2000 Pro subwoofer worth your money? If you're thinking of upgrading and want excellent output, extension, and clean, tight bass, then I definitely think it is. If you're coming from an entry-level sub, then this will be a whole world of difference. It has tremendous output and offers room-shaking bass at a price that I think is pretty reasonable. Obviously, this is not the top of the line when it comes to subwoofers, and there are others that outperform it, though at a higher price point than what SVS is asking. Overall, if you're looking for a subwoofer to up your game in terms of your home theater, then I definitely recommend checking out the SVS PB2000 Pro. Links are in the description. Now, if you enjoyed this review and found it helpful at all, please feel free to give it a big thumbs up. It lets me know that you appreciate this type of content. Thank you everyone for watching, and I'll see you in the next one where I watch the opening race scene in Ready Player One over and over again.
The Artemis, the Sixer Fixer,